Does the bright sunlight help your vision cycling?
I mean, the sun does hurt my eyes sometimes.
It hurts your eyes?
I mean, if I'm looking right into it.
No, but I just didn't have anything lit up.
Right. Yeah, things being lit up is good.
I like nighttime for Bob, right?
Yeah, I like things being lit up. Some reasonably placed charros. Well,
okay.
I think we're split up. Did everyone get through?
We're good.
All right. Coming up on your left. Never been anywhere near here before. What happened just
before? They were trying to release the traffic, but they didn't pass. Stopping.
Just don't keep the stop signs when you are one vehicle.
So what's going on?
Me?
Yep.
Well, at the moment, my niece is with her dad. She wants to help her pick out a new one, but I'm here and she's in Ohio. So, stopping. No, this is Mike's. Oh, okay.
Okay. Hopefully he'll do something intelligent with it.
going home on Sunday?
Yep.
Sunday.
Oh, really? Because there is a ride scheduled for Sunday.
We're going to skip it and head home.
Okay. No, so I didn't see it, but I noticed it after everyone else noticed it.
You mostly ride the road? You do any mountain biking or any other type of biking?
No, pretty much it's all just for transportation. I tried mountain biking once and I don't think it's for me.
Yeah, it's a different set of skills.
Yeah.
You gotta go a lot slower. Some people are, you also gotta progress. Sometimes people take you out on a mountain bike and take you on way too hard a trail.
Right.
It sours your taste.
Also, I'm at risk for detached retina, so it's probably not very safe for me to do mountain biking.
Yeah. A lot of careful stuff in the eyes.
Yeah.
Ride in the wintertime. If we get too much snow, we go out with snowshoes and pack it down, and then we ride on top of that with the bike. And we only go maybe 4 hours, you know, 4 miles in 2 hours. I mean, it's a much, much slower pace.
Right.
And we can try that.
Here we go. Yep. Hi.
2, 4, 6, 8 All right.
Who do we appreciate?
Yeah, I just wanted to make it even.
Thank you.
Hope I'm not stopping too short for you.
Okay. I'm never quite sure what you can see.
Well, I'm never really sure what I can see either.
Great.
I mean, because what do I compare it to?
Yeah, that's fair enough. Heads up.
Thank you.
Back there in the park where there was a gate across the road.
Yeah,
It looked like it kind of took you by surprise.
Yeah, it did.
Would you appreciate tips from able-sighted people?
No, I think it's okay. Yeah, thanks. It was just that one thing, but I think in general I'm okay. We all here?
That's another one. Alright. Two-tone.
Yeah, it was built into the bank.
Right. boat. Coming up on your right. What?
I kinda like the smell.
Oh, what smell?
The hot smell.
Oh, yeah.
I don't always like hot smell, but I like that one.
Cool. I thought they had moved to Belgium or something, the beer company. Maybe just the leadership, maybe the factory is the... Sorry.
It's in the field.
Dr.
Root.
Yeah, it's like what you said.
Right.
Coming up on your left.
Darren, you don't want to stop at Soulard Market?
I don't
want
to stop
at Soulard. That's fine. To our left is Soulard Market. There's been a public market on this bus since 1796. This is the 1929 incarnation. Still open. And we're on a Saturday morning at St. Louis Urban is one of the best.
Public meaning like you can go there to sell
public
your own
market.
Stuff?
The public market, right, still today.
Oh wow, that's really cool. And it's like you can go there anytime. Harold. And not like specific hours, like you can go there anytime.
Specific hours.
Oh.
River is half a mile in front of us.
Here we go.
Yeah, take care. Good to see you.
Oh yeah, I see. coming up on your left. Coming up on your left. What's that?
Is that a better ride?
Than what?
Than a double, a tandem?
Oh, yeah, much easier. Oh.
Lots of bumps here.
Watch it.
Thank you.
coming up on your left. What's it? Oh.
Exactly, yeah, and then it's getting more like that.
Oh, watch out. Stopping.
Are you doing anything like with better design, worse design type stuff as far as what kind of implement?
Not yet. Eventually we do want to do a design course.
Okay.
But when it comes to resources,
for a green light.
Oh.
Yeah.
go.
Trying to get down. I mean, we got two vehicles to go, but They're both under 10, probably about 10, 12,000 miles a year. His wife drives the boat to the bus stop, and then she takes the bus down. So that's nice. You go 4 miles to the bus stop, and then it goes that way. That's a great thing for us. We had like 5,500 miles on the car, and we put like 50 gallons of gas in. So it's almost like, because we charge it up all the time, we run out of electricity.
I like that.
But to try to get it down to those types of miles, bro, turn 6,000 miles in 6 months. We're still putting on more miles. But we got family. This is like the third time we've been back to St. Louis. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm actually in Illinois, so I'm just commuting in into the city.
Well, watch out.
Come on, your bike.
mountain bike race in Breckenridge called the Firecracker 450. But you take part of the bike home away.
I see it.
Oh, look at that. Whoa, watch it.
No.
Whoa. Incredible. I didn't know that even went up like that.
Yeah, she hit the loop.
Okay.
Good job, Lyle. Good job.
Wow. Good save, man.
What the hell? I have no idea what was going on there.
I've missed seeing those posts before. And they've been mounted on both ends, and I hit it, and I flipped right over it.
Oh, wow.
Pirouetted right on my head.
I know someone who ran into a chain once. That was pretty bad.
Yeah. That was bad, yeah. Back on a mountain bike trail, and it got dark, and I thought I had a light, and I didn't.
Oh, shit.
I'm trying to find my way out. I ran across this old logging road.
There are other groups that I'll ride with the crash. And we have some big rides. I mean, we were effective at killing critical mass.
Yep.
You get,
I couldn't really.
On the coast, you get some snow out there, don't you?
Yeah. But, yeah, I mean, I couldn't really get where I need to go any other way.
Yeah. Just throw on some different tires and...
Yeah, I use studded tires. Right turn into left lane.
Right turn into left.
Okay.
it pretty hilly where you're at?
Yeah, it's pretty hilly. There's a pretty big hill if I want to get to the next town south. It's like 600 foot rise within a mile. And that's like kind of the extreme. But there are a lot of smaller hills.
Yeah. It's all pretty flat around here.
Yeah. There's pretty much like, you're almost never going level. You're either going up or down.
Unless you're going along the river or something, following the river or something like that.
Right. Yeah, it might be. The slope might be really slight, but you're still either going up or down.
Yeah.
Where do you live again?
Pardon?
Where do you live again?
Omaha, Nebraska.
Oh, okay. I imagine it's pretty flat there.
Yeah, I can imagine, but it's got more like rolling. Like
well, watch
rolling.
Out.
It's not 600, but just 100.
Yeah.
I ended up with, we got a geographic information system map that has a topo layer in it. So I went through and manually counted the topo lines. And hooked up all the streets that have 5% grade or less. Just to save, so you don't have to do any extra climbing.
Right. What was that?
And then tried to coordinate that with different colors based on how much traffic is on the street.
Yeah.
Black streets are, you know, there's traffic when there's rush hour, but the rest of the time it's fine. And then we got red streets that we're busy outside of rush hour too. But a lot of times, you know, you get beyond 7:30 at night, you can pretty much ride any road you want.
Yeah.
Especially with four lanes. That was four lanes. I'm always able to pass them. The two lane beat, there's less people out there, and you got people speeding a lot.
Yeah, there's a lot of, where I live, there's a lot of busy two lane roads, and it gets very uncomfortable.
Really?
Yeah, because people get, you know, really nasty and aggressive.
Some trails that run along old railroads and then also along creeks.
Nice
the creek. That's how they stay along the creek, you know, so that's the problem is the creeks don't always perform like a south, northwest to southeast diagonal.
Yeah.
So eventually you still gotta figure out how to get wherever you want to go.
Trying to get my speed down to the point that I can use left.
Sometimes I think we're getting better, and then other times you run into a bunch of nasty people like all at once. It's like, I don't know.
Right.
I let off the brakes.
Sometimes people just having a bad day. It really doesn't matter what happens or what you
do. I got the guy in front of that. There's a good turn. So he's pulling a U-turn in front of me and he's saying, I'm sorry, like as he's doing it, because he knows he's just done this stupid thing. He has this big one. Got me here with it. He didn't know exactly what he meant, but I am not
fortunately nobody was coming in the oncoming lane. I was fishtailing all over the place, and miraculously I didn't crash, but you know, basically because I was going quite fast and I had, you know, some gyroscopic stability.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I knew enough not to tighten up on the bars.
Yeah.
So, you know, you like let up, take it loose,
right,
lay off the brakes.
Yeah.
Everything's on.
Shore Gavin and Coffee are still open.